Heather from Artisan Talent, and we're talking about back-end developers. Mm-hmm. We talked about this a second ago. What's the difference between back-end developers and front-end developers?
Well, the back-end is a little bit more technical. So it's really, I would say, the foundation is a good way of looking at it for what's to come with maybe a design or an idea that you will visually eventually see. So this is the very intricate framework to build upon to make something visual.
Okay, cool. And what kind of skill sets are you looking for? You obviously have lots of freelance projects, mm-hmm. lots of full-time positions run past your desk. What kind of skills are you looking for with back-end web development?
Well, someone has to be very passionate about this. Someone that really understands, I would say, the whole process. So maybe they have a background in engineering or web development or something like that, and they have kind of found that they really do enjoy the back-end side, which could be working in Ruby on Rails, which is something that we see quite a bit. PHP, they understand SQL. Maybe they've connected with, you know, the C++. We don't touch that too much, but that's important to know. But understands it through the HTML and CSS and JavaScript and jQuery libraries. So someone understands all of that to give to a designer is really, really, really important. And if they're efficient and quick and clean with their code, hands down, they will be definitely a very happy person.
They'll be snapped up by
yes.
your clients. Tell me, what kind of projects can a back-end developer expect? And, you know, what kind of back-end programming, what kind of back-end database work, what kind of back-end coding mm-hmm. could they expect through, you know, through their career?
You know, every once in a while we see something maybe that's like a full stack developer. So that's someone that understands back-end development with the front-end. So those are occasional. Usually companies split it, or projects are split between a front-end person and a back-end person too. So maybe someone that's really good at Ruby on Rails or a Ruby developer. Those are the ones we see a lot of, because someone has to really, really be passionate about that. Mm. And they might have to understand PHP, how it's integrated into a database that they use with a company or a CMS tool or something. So understanding how to connect all the dots like that is really, really, really important. You'll see sometimes like a SQL be thrown in there, or maybe they need to understand Angular or CoffeeScript a little bit more on the front end, just to be able to communicate with a front end person.
Okay, cool. So let's say you have a person who has got those kind of skills,
yeah.
who has that kind of passion,
mm-hmm.
is interested in those kind of projects.
Yes.
What kind of money, what kind of salary, whether it's freelance or full-time, could a back-end developer expect?
This is an area that if you're really serious about, you can do very well. So, you know, I would say, you know, currently we're working on some Ruby positions, you know, and as far as an hourly rate range goes, for they're looking for someone in that 4 to 6 years. It's anywhere from like 40 to 70 an hour.
So 46 years experience.
Yes, exactly. But then there has been full-time roles that have rolled through, and maybe they're more in that, you know, 120 to 150 range.
That's pretty serious for a programmer.
Yes, but if you think about it, in this digital age we're in, wouldn't you want your foundation, you know, handled by somebody that's an expert in that area? And I feel like we connect with those people. You know, we talk to them about what makes them tick, why they got into development, why they're good at back end, and here we are.
And my understanding, wrapping this little thing up here, is that you're talking about someone who is more so left brained, logical, analytical,
yes.
less so right brain, which is sort of more your, if you will, communication, emotional, connected.
Mm-hmm.
So I can see how, and this is a biased question, I can see how having a talent agency might be an advantage.
Yeah.
Tell me, what for a back-end developer,
yeah.
what kind of advantage would there be in enlisting with a talent agency like Artisan?
It helps them kind of get out of their shell, and not to, you know, kind of go off on that. Someone they can trust. You know, I like to talk to developers because I love to hear that analytical side about them, and what they've put together is amazing to me, and you know how they're putting code together. But being a voice for them, maybe giving them some confidence,
mm.
giving them some coaching tips, like, hey, this is the type of samples we need. This is what you're going to expect when you go on an interview. This is the type of project. So it gives them kind of a heads up. And I know someone that's very methodical and maybe very analytical likes to be kind of excited to know what's to come. So
mm.
really helping them feel confident in that space is another sort of, I guess, advocate area we can be part of.
All right, cool.
Mm-hmm.
So if someone wants to reach out as a back-end developer, as a back-end
mm-hmm.
coder,
yes.
To maybe get some work through you guys
mm-hmm.
or an agency like you, what's the best way to reach Artisan? I know you guys are kind of everywhere, right?
Yes, we are. But you can pick up the phone, you can find us online, you can go through LinkedIn, you can find us at an event. Don't hesitate to come up and talk to us.
All right, thanks so much for your help.
Mm-hmm.